This is MX Master 3S, a $100 mouse from Logitech, and it has a wheel that rotates for a long time. A long, long time. Logitech claims that it can scroll up to 1000 lines per second, and when I tried it in an online test, it scored a whopping 50,000 pixels per minute, compared to a standard wired mouse which only did 2000 pixels per minute. So I was wondering, how does this mouse wheel rotate at such high speeds? And even bigger question is, do we actually need such a high-tech mouse? This is the Logitech V100, a basic $5 wired mouse. It can do all the basic functions you want. It can click, right-click, scroll, and do scroll with the click. For most people, that's enough. But the problem here is that when I flick the scroll wheel, the page barely moves. It goes down just one small frame at a time. And if you have to scroll through a long web page, you have to keep flicking, flicking, and flicking. Now imagine you're a designer or a creator, and you have to use 3D CAD software or Adobe Suite or any other video editor. That means hours of zooming in and zooming out, either on 3D models or on layers in Adobe Suite. And sometimes scrolling left and right across long timelines while editing the video. So here's the problem. When you're doing all of this with a mechanical ratchet wheel that works with a spring, every tiny movement needs a lot of effort, and that slows you down. And after hours of work, your index finger starts to hurt. This is where this max speed wheel in MX Master comes into the picture and changes everything. You do just one flick and the wheel spins freely. You can scroll thousands of lines per second and reach to the end of the web page in just one flick. And why do you need that? Because sometimes during research or just browsing, you may want to know how big the whole article is before you even start reading. And for your work, you can zoom in and out effortlessly, both for 3D models and for layers in Illustrator. So no more flicking and zooming frame by frame. But before we tear down this mouse to see how this max speed wheel works, you might be thinking, why there is an extra scroll wheel on the side? What are these small buttons? And why is this mouse curved? Relax. As always, let's see the design and the features one by one. On the left side of the mouse, just above the thumb rest, you'll find a dedicated horizontal scroll wheel. This wheel is made for side scrolling. Perfect for navigating timelines in video editing software, moving across large spreadsheet, or scrolling through wide design canvases in Illustrator or Figma. Unlike traditional mice, where you have to hold shift and then scroll, this wheel lets you scroll sideways instantly with a smooth and controlled motion. Although this wheel is not max speed like the main scroll wheel, but it has a very smooth and slow motion that gives you precise control without accidental movements. Moving to the top, you have the left and the right click buttons. Unlike regular mice that use mechanical switches, Logitech has upgraded these buttons with quick click technology. This makes them about 30% quieter than the MX Master 3. But that depends on your preference. Personally, I prefer the MX Master 3 click instead of the new 3S. And right below the main scroll wheel, there's a small button. This is the mode shift button. By pressing this button, you instantly switches between two scrolling modes. First is the free spin mode that I already showed you, in which the wheel spins freely and endlessly, perfect for flying through long pages or large documents. And second is the traditional ratchet mode, moving one step at a time. This gives you precise controlled scrolling with small clicks like a traditional mouse, but without the extra pain. In this mode, you can also switch automatically to free spin mode if you flick fast enough. And then it comes back to the ratchet mode again when the wheel stops. How it actually works, that we'll see in a bit when we'll go inside the mouse. But before that, let's have a look at these two buttons on the side that can really transform your workflow instantly. These are undo and redo buttons. If you're working in Photoshop, Illustrator, or any creative software, these buttons are a lifesaver. Instead of pressing Ctrl+Z on the keyboard every time, just tap the undo button to go back. Need to redo a change? The redo button does that instantly. These buttons are positioned perfectly within the thumb's reach. meaning you can undo and redo actions without moving your mouse or lifting your hand. You can also program these buttons to go forward and backward in a browser or file explorer without clicking the arrows on the top. And there's another hidden button right where your thumb rests. This is called the gesture button, and it's programmable. By default, pressing it opens Task View, letting you switch between open applications instantly. You can also customize it for gestures in the Logi Option Plus app, like press and swipe up to open Start Menu, and press and swipe down to hide all the windows. And all these buttons are placed perfectly at the tips of your fingers and your thumbs, and assembled together in an ergonomic body. The mouse has a soft touch rubberized coating on the top, making it feel premium and providing a comfortable grip. This finish and the ridges on the back prevents your hand from slipping even after hours of use. The curved shape supports the natural position of your hand, reducing wrist strain even after longer hours of use. The lower body of the mouse is made of sturdy plastic with smooth glide pads. There is a Type-C charging port on the front and an optical sensor in the middle that allows it to work on any surface, desk mat, wood, couch, or even glass. Then there's a device switch button at the bottom, so that you can connect to three devices at one time and switch between them with just one click. The graphite finish here on the lower body is even better than top surfaces of many mice that I have ever used. This attention to detail is a sign of a great product design. And now, let's go inside this mouse to see how that max speed wheel actually works. To do that, I'll remove the glide pads to uncover the hidden screws. There's one T5 and 5 Phillips 2 screws that we'll remove one by one. And finally, when you open the housing, there's a ribbon cable connecting the top housing to the bottom. So let's remove this connector from here. Now we have separate upper and lower housing. All the button presses that happens on the top send the commands through this ribbon cable to this circuit board. And here is the max speed scroll wheel. You can see the complexity of the scroll wheel in a $100 mouse and a $5 mouse. All this research and development and extra components drive the price from $5 to $100. Now let's focus on the scroll wheel. The use of stainless steel gives it weight and momentum for smooth spinning. Here, you can see a small electromagnetic coil that controls the motion of the scroll wheel. These two connectors here decide the flow of current in the coil, and that will determine whether the wheel will be in free spin mode or ratchet mode. Let's connect the ribbon cable back to see it in action. Now it's connected. So when the free spin mode is on, the electromagnets either turn off or create a smooth magnetic field. With no resistance, the wheel spins freely with just a flick and eventually stops due to air resistance and air damping. And when you press this button on the top, you change the scroll mode from free to ratchet mode. These two connectors reverse the direction of current and create an alternating magnetic field. This creates tiny resistance points that gives more precision and control in the mouse movements. And if you flick it with a force that is more than resistance provided by the current, it goes into free spin mode and finally come back to the ratchet mode when it stops. You can call it a gimmick, but that is the coolest scroll wheel I have ever seen in a mouse. It has changed my workflow completely. And now, I cannot go back to using any other mouse. But is this the right mouse for you? If you are a designer or video editor who uses Adobe Suite, CAD softwares, or DaVinci Resolve, the max speed wheel will transform how you zoom in and zoom out of 3D models, layers, and timelines. The horizontal scroll wheel will let you navigate timelines and CAD drawings effortlessly without pressing any extra keys. For programmers and writers scrolling through thousands of lines of code or documents, this wheel helps you to reach the right section instantly. Those undo and redo buttons can even be remapped for copy and paste function. And if you are a power user working on spreadsheets or presentations, curved shape provides crucial support to your hand, reducing wrist strain over those long hours. But if you are a pro gamer or are just checking emails and browsing social media, then MX Master might be an overkill for you. Its premium features comes with a premium price tag, and technology should serve a purpose beyond than just being cool. The best purchases are the ones that solve real problems in your workflow. So before dropping $100 on this engineering marvel, ask yourself, will this mouse actually make my daily task better? For me, the answer was a clear yes. For you, that depends on what you're clicking on all day. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.